Mustang 2005 here, and I'm actually doing a test today. I finally got my lapel mic instead of just wearing this thing all the time. So it makes it a lot easier by having the wire. I'm also testing the sound level. Let's see, right now. Right now I have it in middle dB. This is what it sounds like in low dB, like negative 10 or something like that. We'll see how this sounds.
Testing, 1, 2.
Okay. Okay, one more test.
Testing, 1, 2. Anthony Arrigo and Rika Shimojo with Mustang 2005.
Yeah. Just making sure of the sound levels, you know, I gotta get those perfect because then people get mad. This is the highest level, it's probably the worst. And this is the lowest. See how the ambient noise is? Now we'll go to middle level. See if you can hear the water. And yeah. So that's pretty much it. Just taking the drone up. And that's pretty much it for this video. It's just a test video. Just a quick video, but oh, a beautiful day. Couldn't be any more perfect. It's a perfect day, like, oh my God. The temperature is 73, absolute ideal. The humidity is perfect. Everything is perfect today. Beautiful. You know, gotta test the sounds, make sure everything sounds good. You know, I gotta make quality footage. I can't make shitty quality footage. You know? So yeah, that's about it for today. Just a quick little video, enjoying the weather at Crescent Beach. And well, that's it. So I'll see you guys later.
Look at all these swarms of birds. It's kind of weird. At first they were all like running away from the shore, now they're like all coming over here. I don't know what's going on. Very strange. It's like Alfred Hitchcock, birds.
I don't know, it's kind of a random excursion here. I was only gonna make a quick video, but now it's turning into an adventure video. So me and Andre were here before, but I never really got to check it out. This is very interesting, there's like random stairs there. I don't know, this area is like very interesting. There's all kinds of stuff here.
I like the little shell work.
Yeah, the shells, like some nice Italian bread. Someone's gonna have an Italian Sunday dinner.
Yeah, you could come here and sit and relax.
Yeah. Look at all these little things here.
You know what I like about Staten Island for the most part? Like if you go to any of these beaches, there's like one person here.
Yeah.
Because it's not on the thoroughfare, like where people are getting off the train and the beach is right there, like Coney Island.
Right.
So here, every beach is its own private Idaho.
Yeah.
This is really cool.
Yeah. Look at this, he's got his grill there, whoever's grill it is.
He's got two grills.
Yeah. This is awesome.
This is pretty sick.
But this is public property, so it's not like I'm on someone's, you know, private. Wow. This is cool. Looks like there's two fires going on there. The adventure continues at this spot again. If you saw episode 5 of Staten Island Beaches and Coastlines, me and Andre were also here, where those abandoned houses were. I found out what this place was. I just don't remember now. I know Doris Day was there, that's all I remember. There was some kind of settlement, I don't know. There's all these birds again. What?
Nobody lives.
No, this is like an abandoned old settlement.
Hit my head on the rock. Yeah, they put out both fires.
Yeah.
What's funny is when I worked in the World Trade Center, I was on the 79th floor, and every fire in the city, I saw it. We'd be like, oh, look, there's
a
fire. You'd see a little black thing of smoke, very black, and then all of a sudden it turns white, and then it goes out.
You were there when it got hit?
No. Oh. I was working on Broadway, and I was working nights and coming in at 11. Well, 12. I was coming in late and staying until late. I was staying until 12.
Yeah.
So I was doing that type of shift. So I was sleeping when the planes were coming. I heard one. I lived in Bay Ridge. It flew right by my apartment. And I remember thinking, oh, it's the Blue Angels. Because at the time, they were around. They would do, like, practice. And, you know, so I figured, oh, the Blue Angels. It was so loud. And then all of a sudden my phone started ringing and I didn't answer it.
Mm-hmm.
And it was my parents and my mother screaming in the background, tell them not to go to work. And my father's like, Anthony, there's a terrorist attack, you know, this and that. I wish I still had that tape. And I answered it. And then when I was on the phone with them, another plane hit. And then, you know, we already thought it was terrorism because we're not stupid. And
yeah, I remember sitting in school and watching on TV and I was like, wait, what? Is this real life? What is going on here?
Right.
I thought like it was a movie or something. I don't know. It was surreal.
It really was.
That's you're just sitting there in shock with your mouth open like you're watching it happen and it's like
different news like, oh, a plane hit the Pentagon.
And then at first you thought like maybe it was an accident and then the second plane comes and you're like, whoa, what is going on?
Losing a war here.
Yeah.
I thought World War III.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Worth it.
Yeah?
This is incredible.
Yeah?
Yo, this is something else. I've never knew this was here.
So much easier to climb without a backpack.
This is like maybe almost 30 feet.
Wow.
Look at that vast, open, little, cute bay here.
Yeah.
And the climb is fun.
This is all private beach, too.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, I think so. Because there's no way to get there. I looked on a map.
Dude, I'm not a big drinker anymore, but one night I want to definitely come during sunset, just relax with a bottle.
Yeah.
Have a few glasses of wine. just appreciate the sunset and on a beautiful night.
Yeah.
Rika, you gotta come. There's a whole old bay here that's like goes in. It's really nice.
I'm calling this video Staten Island Excursion.
We did everything.